Blackstone Publishing presents Journeys North, The Pacific Crest Trail by Barney Scout Mann. This book is read by Traber Burns. To my parents, Don and Mickey Mann, alternate, Don and Mickey Mann, there for my first step. To my wife, Sandy Frodo Mann, alternate, Sandy Frodo Mann, there every step of the way. Author's note. Welcome to a world where Amanda is Blazer, my wife Sandy is Frodo, Paul is Bounty Hunter, and Tim is Figaro. On the Pacific Crest Trail, no one knows me as Barney, they only know me as Scout. Names like these are a long trail tradition. But you don't pick your trail name. Your fellow hikers do. There's a story, often embarrassing, behind each one. Journeys North follows six thru-hikers, and just as if you were on the trail, people are referred to by their trail name once they have one. More than a village, it feels like a whole town helped create this book. To all of you, thanks. Introduction. Frodo's Birthday. Tuesday, October 2nd, 2007. Blazer couldn't feel her toes. In the pre-dawn gloom, the 25-year-old stomped a path over a foot of fresh snow, but the effort barely blunted the cold. This was the second blizzard in 3 days, as the Gulf of Alaska hurled once-in-a-generation storms at Washington's Cascade Range. After 5 months hiking the Pacific Crest Trail, Blazer was wearing her fifth pair of running shoes, and the studded soles were ground flat, much like her muscles, sinews, and joints. She'd come over 2,600 miles, only 40 left to reach Canada. She'd sworn days before, "I'll crawl if I have to." Right behind her, Frodo and I brushed fat snowflakes from our bent shoulders and packs. A dim light penetrated the pine and spruce thicket. "Happy birthday, Frodo," Blazer piped up. We jerked as if poked. In the 30 years we'd been married, I'd never forgotten Frodo's birthday. But this time, focused on the cold, on not getting lost, and on surviving, we both had. "What do you want for your birthday?" Blazer asked. Frodo, her breath visible, didn't hesitate. "I want to finish the day alive." Two more storms swept in over the next 3 days, smothering the Pacific Crest Trail in thigh-high drifts. On Thursday night, Seattle King 5 TV News reported, 3 Pacific Crest Trail hikers are missing. Chatter lit up the internet within minutes. Goodness, it's so cold now. May the Lord protect them. Past midnight, one of 60 soon-to-be rescuers wrote, I am headed out to Stevens Pass to work the search. But they weren't searching for us. They were searching for Nadine.
Sand. Campo to Agua Dulce. 454 miles.
Chapter 1. Will We? Saturday, April 28, 2007. Sandy strode into the Lake Morena campground at 10 a.m., her tanned, freckled cheeks flush from the desert heat. 10 miles this morning meant she was right on time. 20 dusty miles behind her was the start of the Pacific Crest Trail at the Mexican border. My wife is a 5'2" timepiece. I can set my watch by her, just as her high school biology students did for years. Taking 4 steps to my 3, Sandy is fond of saying that we foxtrot and waltz up any trail, marking 4-4 and 3-4 time. This discordant dance has carried us far. As the child of an engineer and a home economics major, she has planning and punctuality in her genes.
With the same fervor that she applied to earning her Ph.D., Sandy had worked up a 149-day itinerary for our hike of the PCT. All 2,650 miles, day upon day.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.